Hey guys, I'm Lucian, and thanks for checking out this video today. I'm so excited. I just got done finishing up the guitar tracks to this song that I just composed using these drum grooves, which we're going to talk about. So if you're not familiar with what this is about, Go Independent Records has released a series of apps for the iOS phone and for the iPad. With drum grooves, and there's all different types of apps. What drew me to their apps is the Steve Gadd app. And what that is Steve and them collaborated and made a series of drum loops and grooves that Steve personally likes and that he uses and so on and so forth. And of course, anyone who has been following me for any period of time knows that my deep-rooted love and passion is jazz and jazz fusion. And I grew up listening to Steve Gadd. And when I write, I have him in my mind at all times. My favorite drummer, bar none. He's the one, along with other guitar players of that time and obviously other musicians, growing up on that, it's infused in your body and you just have to, you know, seek out that style when you're writing. And that's what I usually do all the time within my jazz and my jazz fusion music. So when I got a hold of this app, I was just completely blown away. So I'm going to go into that a little bit later on in the video. But what this is about is for you to hear and see how the app is actually used within constructing a song. All right, so give a listen to the song. And also for you guitar players, I'm doing something a little different. In the video of the song, you're gonna see me playing the rhythm parts that I laid for it. If I play the lead along with what's going on, it can be a distraction, basically, because it's not a video about guitar playing or learning any riffs or anything like that. However, if there's enough interest, I will definitely put out another video with the guitar stuff within this song. So you'll see me playing along just for the rhythm's sake, and you see how the rhythm and the grooves are just so good within this app and what Steve Gadd had laid down with these guys. All right, so let's listen to the video and then we'll get back together and I'll just give you a run through of what I did. All right, guys, so this is where you can find the app. It's in the App Store. It's by Go Independent Records. And you can see they have a more than one app here, so it's pretty cool. They're all really nice. Great apps. So there on the left, we see our drum loops by Steve Gadd. Right, so you grab that. And what we're going to do is pop over to that. And so we're in it, right? So fantastic stuff. There he is, the man right there. So I'll just do a quick overview of this. It pops up. Now, obviously, these are, you don't get a gazillion of them. Like if you're used to working with a lot of drum loops, like in Superior Drummer, like I was mentioning. There's a fair amount, though, I should have to say. And with that, you can definitely manipulate different beats by changing the tempos and using the different fills, because there's a fill section, which I'm going to show you. You can also steal out of each of the grooves where there is a fill. You can copy and paste just that if you know how to maneuver loops. So the better you get at it, the better it's going to sound, for sure. All right, so it's broken down. You have Steve's favorite tempos. Yeah, just sweet grooves, man. Sweet grooves. Just these alone. You know, the sound of that drum set, Yamaha Recording Custom, so on and so forth. We could be here all day. Right? So, then of course you have the cowbell versions of these. Again, I'm not going to run through all of these different tempos. So you can see it's a group of eight there of all of the tempos on the top there. So famous grooves, obviously the ones that Steve is famous for, you know. Those wonderful grooves you can see there. Asia, of course. How sweet is that? Right, so it goes on and on. Brushes are awesome. Actually, I'm working on a song right now that's using the brushes, which I'm going to be posting that as well. 4/4 grooves. And then this is where the fills come in. You can see on the bottom. Very nicely recorded drum set. You can read about the whole thing. It tells you where it was recorded and so on and so forth. It's a very cool app. And not only for the beats, but it's just awesome. 6/8 grooves. Oh, and getting back to those fills again. Let me go back to where I was here. Fills on the bottom there. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So you have 6 to choose from within this 80 beats per minute. At 90 beats per minute, so on and so forth. You have all those beats and fills. So like I said, you do get a fair amount of them. And like I said, when you use this option here, GB or DAW, it's how to paste and bring it into GarageBand or your DAW, which I'm going to show you a little bit in just a few seconds here. But that's how they go in there. So as I was saying, with the GarageBand, the GB, which I was never really a big user of GarageBand until now, getting this app and trying to make this happen for myself to get these recorded. What happens is you have to bring it into GarageBand on your iOS and then create the song, and then just it bounces down as a two-track left and right of your complete drum loop mix, and then you can put it into your DAW and start recording over that. And that's what I did here. That's what you heard in the song. Yeah, only the grooves in this app were used in that song. And I'm going to go over to GarageBand and show you that. But let me get through the rest of this here. 6/8. Again, this video is not about taking you through each one. It's just buy the thing and start using it. It's just going to be awesome. Now, this is really cool. Some nifty fills, or what they're calling endings. Again, you can copy and paste a lot of this stuff and bring it in different areas of your song. Samples are on the bottom, which is just single crashes. And obviously, you guys that know how to use loops would know you definitely need a crash or two to complement the changes that you're making if the loop doesn't have it, and or if you're just creating another section, you definitely want to have the crashes going in there. And of course, the kick is always in there, or should be in there when a section is changing, but the groove already has the kick in it. So you can kind of just lay this these crashes in, which I'm going to show you because I, like I said, in the song that we just did, or I just did, has all this stuff. So I'm going to show you that when we get there. But it's really cool that for an app like this, not only do you get drum grooves and loops, but you get the fills and some crashes and just some extra little things that would complement the sound. So you don't have to look to any other software to do the fill-in stuff to make your loops or make your song the way that you want. Now, I could have, because like I said, I use Superior Drummer, and I could have went obviously crazy and added a lot of different things in that song, but I really wanted to keep it straight just to what is in this app only, and which is magical. You don't even need to use anything else, and you wouldn't want to because the sound is so good, and each one of these crashes is right from his set. So yeah, you can use other software and bring in crashes and kicks and things like that. But why not use the same sound as what was already mixed down or already and already used in these loops? So fantastic stuff. Okay. Instructions on how to do everything, which I'm going to show you a little bit now. The mics used, the instruments, well, obviously, you know, it's the Yamaha Recording Custom and the sizes and everything, if you need that information. And then, of course, other apps by this great company here. All right. So, like I said, now what you do is you have this app open. I'm going to go over to our GarageBand session here. This is the actual session that this song Chillin is. So you can see there's, for this one, I made four different tracks. The top one is the groove, or the grooves, I should say, the ones that were, you know, when I was scrolling through them, what one spoke to me immediately was this one. And like I said, it's such a pleasure to work with because you can end up getting so creative because of the sound and obviously because the way that Steve plays. And he just makes you write. So I should actually have included him in the writing credits of that song. Because, to be honest, that song wouldn't have been written if these grooves were not in it. Period. The end. So let's take a look at that. The first row is the grooves, the actual loops themselves. The second row is the drum fills. Like here, I can play that. See that little patch of that waveform there is just of the fills, and that goes across the whole length of the song wherever I needed a fill change in there, all the way to the end. Another fill that ends it down here. Then you'll notice there's a crash cymbal and a soft cymbal that's underneath that. Let's go back to the beginning of this. So what that is, obviously, if you're having a fill, or even let's go back to the beginning of the song there, right? Track 3 is the crash cymbal, and that's the louder cymbals that I chose to have, that usually would signify the change of a section. And then under that, on track four, is a softer, which I was showing you those cymbals where they are. Right in the app, which was here. Soft, and of course some loud ones there. Right, so those are the ones that I copied and pasted and brought over to my session and used them as the crash cymbal, the one that's louder, and the softer one that's underneath that in the on track four. And those are kind of in between stuff, you know, like little accents that the music would have gave. Here, let's play a little section of that there. That was a section change. So the fill was there, the crash cymbal ended or started the next phrase, and that little soft cymbal, which was right here, kind of came in just as the fill was happening. I'll do that again because I was talking. You know, you can go crazy. You can make however many tracks GarageBand allows you to make. Which I probably would have done if I really had to make this, you know, if I wanted to spend a lot more time on it. But I did spend a fair amount of time on it. Just was a little bit of a learning curve for GarageBand because I'm used to Pro Tools. But GarageBand is great. And to be honest, this is the only way that this app or these grooves are going to get into your DAW, or at least that I'm aware of. So what you do is exactly what I did here. You're piecing your sections, you're bringing in grooves, which I'll show you. I'll just tag it on to the end of the song. We'll make believe that I'm going to add a few more to this. All right, so this is the end of the song. So let's go back there. And if you were to create the song, like I said, I don't want to go into this whole thing about how to use this, but let me demonstrate how to bring a loop in and maybe a crash cymbal, right? So you go back over to the app, and let's see what I was using there. Obviously, Steve's favorite tempos are also mine because he's the one that played them. And that's actually the main beat. That was just gorgeous to work with, and this is a killer one here. So I'm already using that in the song, so let's see, do I use this one? Yeah, that one's in there too. I think I used all of these. This is the section that I was actually using, this 88 BPM, that's what the song's in, and I used most of these. So let's add another one in there, like as if I wanted to extend the song, right? So Let's pop one of those in. So again, we're going to use the GB. The GB is the GarageBand pasteboard. And what that means is when you paste a loop in like so, if you change the tempo, it's going to stay locked in to whatever tempo that you are changing it to. Whereas if you use the DAW, this guy, and bring it over and paste it in, it's not going to lock into the tempo. So that's the beat. Now, if you want, you can shorten it. Let's just shorten it for a moment. And of course, sometimes the beat ain't going to leave off maybe the way that you are anticipating. So you'll have to put something with a crash or a kick there, as I was saying earlier. But I'm just going to stick one of the symbols into that. So go into our endings. Let's grab that one. And if I didn't mention this already, this doesn't have the GarageBand paste. It just has the DAW pasting, because that's not going to matter. So we can pop that in there, and there's our symbol. And of course we can shorten that if we want. And you know, if that's the only thing you want to add in there, you'd probably want to add a fill here before a crash, obviously. But you know, that's pretty the basics of it, right? It's very easy to do. And as you're writing, you'll get into a really good flow with that. So that's pretty much really what we should cover here, because this video can get rather lengthy. But overall, man, not hard at all. You make a few tracks, you go over, you throw them in, you write your song accordingly, you make room for your fills, put a few crashes in there, and you are set to go. All right, so there you have it. That's how I used this great application with Drum Grooves to write, along with Steve Gadd. Having him personally in my studio was just an honor, a very big inspiration. So thanks for checking out this video. Definitely check back. Another video will be coming out very shortly with Steve's Grooves again. It's another song that is in the working, because it's just so exciting and so inspirational. And if you are a fan of his playing, and also of any other loops that this company has to offer, you should check it out and start writing with it, because it's very, very, very inspirational. All right, so until next time, I'll see you then.